Good morning and welcome back, children. Today we are continuing the chapter Water, a Natural Resource, and included three questions from this chapter. We have already completed. There are three parts of the earth which we get natural resources from of various types. You can see lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Lithosphere is the earth, solid earth crust from which we get the rock, soil, minerals and metals. At the same time, the water body is like a river, lakes, ocean, and whatever the water body which we get water from constitute the hydrosphere. And the atmosphere is the airy or gaseous component above the earth surface. And this also we get various types of gaseous minerals, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and many more. So these are the three parts of the earth from where we get the natural resources. Okay, right. After studying that, we completed the renewable and non-renewable natural resources. This renewable and non-renewable natural resource is tentative and can be changed from time to time. The concept of renewable and non-renewable can be changed from time to time. But I have included here some of the questions from that area. Let's now discuss the importance of water in our body. We have already studied the water is the medium in which almost all chemical reactions take place and support the life. Water is a medium for digestion, absorption and excretion. Various substances or nutrients after having digested, they absorb and get transported to various body parts through a soluble form. That means the nutrients get solved in water and become a solution. Unless and until the nutrients get solubilized in water or dissolved in water, it cannot be transported in our body. You know, the blood plasma is the fluid part and it constitutes around 60% of the blood, 60% of the water. Okay, so it is so important. And we can also see that in our body, the temperature maintenance, how to maintain the temperature when our body increases the body temperature due to the atmospheric or ambient temperature, our body temperature also increases. When the body temperature increases, we perspire or sweat. Then the water comes out. Water comes out in the form of sweat along with various waste materials, and it absorbs the heat from our body and get evaporated. So thereby reducing the heat. So water which comes out in the form of sweat get evaporated by absorbing heat from our body, thereby reducing the body temperature. And also we can understand that our body sweat and maintain the water balance and salt balance. We can see that. So in general, we can understand that the water is essential commodity, essential natural resources which support the life. Without the water, no life can exist, individually or in group. That about this question. Now the next one, discuss the importance of water in plants. You might have seen in some places more plants are grown. Why more plants are grown? Because of the availability of water around the water bodies, around the river, around the lakes, around the ponds. We can see lot of water. And human being and animals also sit still where there is water available. You know, when people move, even the ancient time, when the people move from place to place, the nomads, what they do, they sit still in and around the area of a water body. So we can understand that in plants, germination of seeds need water and the growth of the plants need water. It also helps in the transport of nutrients in plants, particularly from the soil to various parts. You know, through xylem, water and minerals are absorbed and get transported So xylem is the conducting channel, conducting tubes through which water and minerals can be taken up from the soil by the roots and get transported to various parts of the body and make available. You know, during you can understand that during the process of photosynthesis, plants need water. Plants absorb water and use in photosynthesis as well, along with the carbon dioxide and sunlight. Plants need water. This water provide the source of electrons in plants for the photosynthesis, and also the oxygen is evolved out. Oxygen that we breathe, all organisms breathe, you know, oxygen, that also coming from water. Coming from water. So besides all these, we must understand that water is essential for, you know, many aquatic organisms, aquatic plants and animals. So the discussion may continue, and you can write, you can imagine and say your own. These are the questions. The first two questions are not to be by-hearted from the text. You can write on your own. That's all. Now the last one, seventh one. As I told you, there are many natural resources which are renewable but exhaustible. Renewable. By natural ways, it can be renewed. Renewed means regenerated or reformed. But through human overconsumption, through, you know, uncontrolled consumption of human being, that may lead to the finishing and completing and what we say, exhausting the natural resources. Such renewable natural resources we call exhaustible natural resources. For example, soil. Soil can be used up, but it is being destroyed. So through soil erosion, it is taken away by moving wind and water. The cutting down of the trees, that affects the soil formation. So soil, forest and groundwater are renewable naturally, but it can also be exhaustible means it can be finished up if we use the rate or faster rate than the rate at which they are renewed in the nature. That's all. Thank you.